Hey guys, I'm Ben from AuthenTech. Today we're checking out the Parrot Bebop 2 FPV drone bundle. Now the bundle kit includes the Bebop 2 drone, FPV goggles, and the long range controller. Some of its main specs include a 2700 milliamp hours battery that's rated up to 25 minutes of flight time, takes about an hour to fully charge, and you can always buy extra batteries on Amazon for around 55 bucks. The 14 megapixel camera can shoot RAW, JPEG, or DNG photos and 1080p video at 30 FPS. Assembly is easy and straightforward. The props are color coded and twist on with the help of an included tool. Size of the drone is quite small, which I like. It kind of reminds me of the Mavic drone from DJI with its small body size. If Parrot can implement folding arms like the Mavic in the future, then it would be ultra portable. The FPV pack comes with a quick start guide, the goggles unit with adjustable head straps, and a 90 degree field of view. The Sky controller too, it feels good in hand, kind of reminds me of an Xbox One controller. It's well balanced, plenty of dials and buttons easily accessible. It has a built-in battery that's rated to last 4 hours of usage, has a maximum range of 1.4 miles with a built-in phone or tablet holder. So let's go out flying. It's marketed as a stable flying platform, and I have to admit, I was very impressed with how well it flies. I've seen all sorts of negative reviews online, and it really blew away my expectations in terms of flying specifically. It's very agile, and the controls are precise and responsive. It drifts a little bit in the wind, but not too bad. It's rated to hit top speeds around 37 miles per hour, and in my test, it just about hit those blazing fast speeds. The camera quality is okay. It's recording video at 1080p, and there's no physical gimbal. It's all image stabilization, but it actually does a pretty amazing job. You can even turn roll stabilization on or off if you want to feel like you're flying in a jet fighter. The low light images were pretty grainy and everything kind of looks muddy overall. I mean, it's not terrible quality, I've seen worse. It's just not beautiful 4K footage like we've seen elsewhere. When you want to fly FPV, the goggles work by sliding out a case that holds your phone with an outlet for the cable and slides back in with split screen view on your phone. This is kind of similar to that Leechy app video I made a while back. I appreciate this feature is baked right in. I found the goggles a bit uncomfortable, hard to balance on my head, and there's no pupil or focal adjustments, which are kind of needed since everyone's eyes are different. Now, I'm a huge fan of flying drones via FPV. It can be a fun and immersive experience. I liked their included OSD and telemetry data easily viewable, and I also liked the helpful arrows and box to show me where my home point was. Unfortunately, I found the latency to be a bit too laggy, so I didn't use the goggles very often. The app has plenty of controls and customization, which I always like. Lots of menu settings to play with. You can easily view, download, or delete your photos and videos remotely in the app. You can have the drone do rolls and flips mid-air. It has a new Follow Me feature, which is great. Kinda lame they're charging extra for these sort of features. They really ought to be free, in my opinion, after you spend hundreds on the equipment itself. Hopefully they change this in the future. Now it has two modes, auto framing, so with image recognition it keeps the subject in the frame while you're flying around, and auto follow, where the drone will follow the target using the smartphone GPS and image recognition. Tracking is very impressive, even visually alone. You can still rotate around or change elevation while tracking your subject. Even if you go under the drone, it can still follow you with no camera gimbal needed. That's an impressive feat. Only a couple times did it lose track of me visually, but the more contrast you can have from your background, the easier it'll make on the quad. Now my only major issue I had was copying files over to my computer. Since there's no SD card slot, kinda lame, it must be connected via USB and powered on. It's mounted as an MTP device. Basically, importing is kind of a pain. I even had some crashing and errors unable to copy files over. I read a tip from the Parrot community forums to use the image capture app on my Mac, and that did make it easier. You can also connect via Wi-Fi and import via FTP, but that's not very easy or convenient either. I kind of wish they just mounted it as a USB mass storage drive, or even better, allowed access to an SD card, but maybe in their next model. So all in all, the price for this whole bundle is normally $700, but Amazon is showing an option for only 500 bucks, and that's actually not bad of a price considering how fast and fun this little drone is. Now, I wouldn't recommend getting it to shoot your next feature film on. It's more just for fun, learning to fly, with safety features built in like return to home and GPS stability, and also great practice for drone racing as it has those precise controls and fast speeds. Plus, the new Follow Me feature is great to play with. So all in all, it's a pretty good package deal. Now I'll give you the link to it down in the video description. Huge thanks to Parrot for sending me the sample unit to review. If you like these drone videos, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more tech videos like this every week. And until next time, let's live authentic.